The Lord God Himself is coming to be with us. His name is Emmanuel. Without Him, the whole world is being ruined. Your life is ruined. The Lord is coming. But take care. You're the vessel. Your life is pure. Don't play around with the world, with the flesh, and thinking that the Lord will come into my life. Sorry. No. I am living my own life. Don't think. God is so patient with you, knowing everything what is happening to you. Don't think God is not punishing you. God is waiting for you patiently, that you will repent for your life. You will rectify your relationship and you will return to Him. He will give you the days of grace. If you don't understand it, if He leaves His hand from you, that is the end of your life. The man dies in sin. Man by himself cannot bear the pain. As long as the sin is in you, the ruler of the sin, Satan, will come into your life. He will take away your health. He will take away your finance. He will play with your family. He will lead you into sin. He will tell you the lie. When you watch pornography, it will make you happy. When you surrender your body to lust, it will make you happy. No, through the sin, He will enter into you and He will take away all that God has given to you. Your family will be ruined. Your health will be ruined. Your finance will be ruined. But He has not thrown you out. The Lord Himself is coming now with a beautiful name called Emmanuel, to be with us, to die for us, to carry away all of our sins, to free us, that we may understand the meaning of love for us. We may understand who is God, who is Jesus for us. If He did not die, there is nobody to free us from the clutches of sin. Look unto Him. He is coming to be with us. Receive Him. Receive Him. Receive Him. Book of 2 Peter chapter 3 verse 9. The word of God says, some people think that though they know the truth, that the wages of sin is death, still they go on play around and they don't understand. They take God for granted. The Bible says, know the truth today, knowing all your sins, still God is not allowing the enemy to destroy you. Though the wages of sin is found in you, though the consequence of sin is already affecting your health, affecting your family, God is not allowing the enemy to ruin your life. He is protecting you. Understand the truth. Before He takes away His hands from you, repent for your sin and return to God. This is what the Lord is telling each one of us. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Don't think, though I am living in my own weakness and sin, nothing has happened to me. No! The Lord is showing patience to you. If He takes away His hands from you, your end will be a horrible one. Today, knowing everything, God is showing patience to you because you are His son, His daughter. He doesn't want you to be perished with the hope that one day you will realize what is happening to you. Who are you? What is the price God has paid for you? you will return to him. With that hope, he is waiting for you. God had blessed David and gave a wonderful nation, but his son lived in sin and he destroyed the nation, and his nation was divided into two. The northern part was known as Israel and southern part is known as Judah. Yes, now the northern part, Israel, is ruled by Ahab, and the southern part, Judah, is ruled by Jehoshaphat. If divine relationship, divine fellowship has to be built up, take care that your human fellowship doesn't take you away from, if there is anything of darkness, dark elements that take you away from the divine fellowship, come out of it. Make a decision. What do you want? Do you want to compromise with the world? Then go. Go ahead. Live as a man of the world. But what you have caught hold in the time of despair, it will destroy you. Your end will be a horrible one. I am your father. I want to be your father. I have come down to save you. I have given my son to die for you. But if my salvation has to be lived in you, you have to see what kind of sin, what kind of darkness is playing with you. Dare to come out of it and you will live by it. When Ahab invited Jehoshaphat, a man of God, he went to Ahab, the evil king, and the evil king is telling, come, let's go for the war. Jehoshaphat says, can we find a prophet? The 100 prophets in his house, they are saying, come on, let's go for the war. Don't think that though you are living in sin, God is not remembering you, or he is simply allowing you to live in sin. No, he gives you opportunity. He wants you to return back. He gives you time to repent for your sin and to return back to God. If you don't return, you will die in your sin. The mercy of God will go away. Shall we all stand up, place both the hands over our heart and pray? John the Baptist says, my dear children, return back to the Lord. I baptize you with the water, but the one who comes after me, he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit. The one who will be with you forever and ever. Commit your life for God. All that you suffered for God will never go waste. One day the Lord will honor you. Your friends may try to take you here and there. Don't throw your precious life. Don't throw away your life for nothing. Don't throw your life for nothing. You are so precious before God. Your life is so precious. Let not that which is eternal be thrown to that which is passing away. That which is life-giving be thrown away, which is meant for today and may disappear tomorrow. Commit to him and live by him. He will anoint you. If you love him, if you seek him with your whole heart, he will not only baptize you with the water, means he will forgive your sins. He will also empower you with the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit will help you, will give you the ability to overcome every trials.
Amen.
The ability to overcome sin.
Amen. Amen.
The ability to overcome temptation.
Amen.
The ability to see things beyond.
Amen.
The ability to see the heaven get opened.
Amen.
The gifts of the Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Lord.
Gift of miracles.
Jesus.
Gift of wonders. Everything is meant for you. You
Amen.
Are God's child.
Amen.
God will provide you. Lord, give me a heart that always seeks thee. I will never take a decision without asking you, Lord. As soon as I get up every morning, train my heart to read your word, to praise you, to worship you. Never should I go to bed without checking my heart, purifying my heart, and making me your child, Lord. My dear friends, Sangamam Plus TV is God's gift for you for our times. Like, comment, share, and subscribe. God will do wonders in your life. Praise the Lord.